Good morning, students. So we are going through the chapter Natural Resources. Today I will explain you about rain and air pollution. So first we will be starting up with rain. So how do rainfall occurs? So rainfall occurs by the following events. So first, what will happen? So many water bodies like lakes, ponds, rivers, oceans, from all these water bodies, the water get evaporated and changes into the water vapor. As this air also get heated up by the sunlight, so along with when air get heated up, it get light, and now the air get moves upwards. So with the water vapor, air moves upward. And when see here, the water evaporates from different water bodies, these goes into the air. And water vapor, these goes into the air along with water vapor. You can write into the air along with water vapor. So air also becomes hot due to sunlight. It started rising up due to the water vapor. As the rises up, it expand and cool. Obviously, when air rises up, because why air is rising up? Because it is very warm air is there due to the sunlight. So warm air rises up, and when it rises up, it will get cool because the temperature is low, and it get cool and condense there. So this cooling causes water vapor in the air to condense and form tiny water droplets. Due when the air get cools, definitely water vapor is also evaporating with it. It will also get cool and get condensed. And when the water vapor get cool and condensed, it will form the small water droplets. Now, the condensation of water is facilitated by dust and other suspended particles. They act as a nucleus for these drops to adhere around. These all, we know that air consists of dust and other suspended particles in it. So, it acts as a nucleus, and all this get adhere around during the process of condensation. And for these droplets, it adhere around an excessive collection of tiny droplets of water vapor in the form of clouds. Now, excessive collection of water vapor get adhere around, and it get condensed over there, and along, and it will all form clouds. So now, once the water vapor form, they grow bigger and bigger in size. Obviously, now the water vapor get cool and condense, it will form a bigger droplet. When it form a bigger droplet, when it will become very heavy and big, it will get fall down into the earth's surface. So in the earlier classes also you read about this, no, water cycle. It's a very common topic. So sometimes when temperature is low enough, precipitation may occur. When obviously when temperature is very low, the precipitation may occur, and in the form of snow, sleet or hail, it will get fall down. As we know, the rainfall patterns are decided by prevailing wind patterns. In large parts of our country, rains are mostly brought by the southwest or northeast monsoons. In some areas, these are caused by the depressions in West Bengal. So this is about the rain. So students, I think you all get clear with it. This topic you are reading from your earlier classes also. That is a water cycle. From the large water bodies, the water get evaporated in the form of water vapor, and when evaporation takes place, water vapor go along with the air, and in the upper part it will cool and condense, and when it will get cool and condense, the dust particles or the suspended particle act as a nucleus, and all water vapor get adhere around, and it will form the clouds. And after that again the water vapor cool and condense, the water droplet will get bigger and bigger in size. When it will get bigger in size and when it will get heavy in size, it will get fall down into the earth's surface. So next, students, I will explain you about the air pollution. So the students, next is air pollution. What do you mean by air pollution? So air pollution is an increase in composition of harmful or undesirable substances in the air is called air pollution. These undesirable substances are called as air pollutants. When undesirable components get mixed up in the air and makes the air polluted, that makes the air polluted, that are called as air pollutants. Or you can say the definition, or you can define the air pollutant as the when these undesirable, when this undesirable substances, or you can say when the undesirable alteration in physical, chemical and biological characteristics of air takes place, then that will be called as air pollution. So now we will study about the causes of air pollution. So first cause of air pollution is excessive burning of fossil fuel. Excessive burning of fossil fuel means burning of coal and petroleum leads to increase or leads to increase the oxides of sulfur and nitrogen in the atmosphere. These are very harmful for the air. These oxides of nitrogen and sulfur, when get mixed up with the air moisture, it will form acid rain. As you know students, acid rain is very harmful for living organism, as well as for the aquatic life, as well as for the land, as well as for the monuments. No, so these all get a this acid rain will definitely, it will very adversely affect for the environment. Or the combustion of fossil fuel also increase the amount of suspended particles particles in air. These suspended particles could be unburnt carbon particles. That is all. These unburnt carbon particles are also called as hydrocarbons. So next, many industries release high amount of poisonous gases. Now, many industries, the effluents of industries, or many gases which is being released from the industries, cause many harmful effects and leads to the air pollution, like CO, or you can say the carbon monoxide. Is one of the most harmful gases which cause pollution, air pollution. So next is dust also cause pollution. So the dust also cause pollution, like allergic problems. You can feel, most of you may be having the allergic problems, asthma, cold, etc. Allergic problems that leads to asthma, cold problems, etc. No, so these all are the causes of air pollution. Next, the effects of air pollution. Next, we will see the effects of air pollution. So the effects of air pollution cause severe damage to the respiratory system and cause it affects the respiratory system. Because obviously, if the polluted air is there, we are inhaling the polluted air, so definitely it affects the respiratory system and causes diseases like asthma and causes disease like asthma, lung cancer, no, etc. Next students, pollutant gases called allergies also. Allergies, irritation. So these polluted air also cause allergies. Polluted air also got allergies or irritation in eyes. Okay, or you can sometimes observe the rashes in the skin. Those people who are allergic to these to this polluted air. No. So next is gases like NO2 and SO2 get dissolved in rain and give rise to acid rain. Oxides, oxide of nitrogen and sulfur, like NO2 and SO2 can give rise to acid rain. That is very dangerous, that I told you. Acid rain is very dangerous for the living organism as well as for the aquatic organism, as well as for the land, irrigation field, as well as for the industrial monuments. No? So next is the presence of high levels of pollution in air reduces visibility. It also sometimes too much of air pollution reduces visibility. It will also cause accidents. Reduces visibility. That also leads to the accident. No. So in cold weather, when water also get condenses out and forms smog, that is the visible indication of air pollution. Last, it also causes greenhouse effect. It also causes greenhouse effect, which leads to global warming. Okay. So these are the effects of air pollution. As you know, students, the lichens are also the pollution indicator. They will not grow in the presence of these oxides of nitrogen and sulfur. Wherever these oxide of nitrogen and sulfur, or you can say the pollutants are present, there the lichens will not grow. So these are the effect of the pollution. So students, today we will study about the rain. How do the rainfall occur? What are the events during that? After that, I explain you about the air pollution and what do you mean by air pollutant, and what are the cause of air pollution, and what are the effects of air pollution. So this is all about the air pollution. So thank you for today's class. All of you go through all these topics again and again and complete your notes as well.